Hey guys, this is Aaron. Today I want to take a look at importing image or PDF files and use them as reference for architectural drawings. And this is, we're using architectural as an example, but anything where I need to draw a model or create a model with high precision. So while we did this with our scale figures drawings, we pulled in images and traced them. I'm talking about a model where I want a little bit more precision than just a general outline. So what I'm going to do, I'm a brand new model here, I'm going to go File, Import, and we'll look at a couple different file types. First one I'm look at is images. So right here I have a JPEG file. I can select that because all supported image types selected. I pick that, make sure use as image is turned on, and import. That's going to come in connected to my cursor, and I can click to a point. And initially I can drag it out a little bit if I want. This is an okay thing to do, but it's not really going to get you to precision, which is what we're looking at in this example. To get a precise image, I have to actually scale the drawing. Now I can see, before I go any further, I want to talk about this image. This is an image that was literally hand-drawn on a piece of graph paper. I took a picture of it with my phone and put it on my computer. So there is nothing precise about this. There's no specific dimensions. I can actually see that the grids of the graph paper aren't orthogonal. So this is the image I'm starting with. Yes, an argument could be made to go take this in the Photoshop and square it up, that sort of thing, but I'm just going to go with what I have. I'm going to use this image. So first thing I'm going to do is scale the model. Before I can scale, I do want to have some sort of a reference line on here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a line across the front of this, what I assume is a garage. Click right there. And then, because when I scale this, I don't want to scale Chris here too, I just want to scale the drawing, I'm going to grab both the drawing and the line. I'm going to right click and make it a group. Now I'm gonna double click into the group. So when I grab my tape measure, it tells me that is 7'6" 1/8". But I'm gonna say I know that based on my years of experience with modeling and drawing and all that sort of stuff, I think I want that to be 12". When I hit enter, it comes up and asks if I want to resize the active group. I'm gonna hit yes. So now that redrew or resized, and I can tell that's 12" right there. So at this point, I can explode the group and delete that line. Now it's a matter of tracing this drawing and getting the dimensions in I want. Now one of the things I can do here is I could just click around, kind of arbitrarily pick points, snapping orthogonally and using this as just sort of a reference for my drawing. But the other thing I might want to do is I might want to actually draw actual length at this point. So if this is supposed to be a 2" section right here, I could type in 2", enter, and continue on around. So right now this is coming out a little over 18". I may want to make that 18" even. I continue around here typing in dimensions using the drawing as reference, or I can actually just, if I'm just trying to get a mass in here, something that I can kind of conceptually work with, I can just click around like that as well. From here on, it's pretty much up to you. You can do this however you want to. But the goal, of course, is just to get my footprint in from that reference drawing. So if I take a look at that once that's in, and see, okay, yeah, I got the general shape even though the lines weren't straight and I didn't have exact locations or dimensions. But this is good enough to start working from right here. So that's great as an example of like a napkin sketch, like I said. But what happens if I have actual plans that I want to pull in? So I have a set of plans. I don't have them as a CAD file, but I do have them as a PDF or image file. Now, quick disclaimer before we go a whole lot further, PDFs can be natively imported on Mac, but not on Windows. In Windows, what you'll have to do is open your PDF in a PDF editor like Acrobat or something like that, and save it out as an image. There's no way to natively import those files through Windows, so we can't pull PDFs in directly. In that case, rather than going to import and picking the PDF file, you can see that shows up under supported image types because it's treated like an image, you would have to save it as a JPEG or GIF or something like that and open it that way. In this case, I'm just gonna click import. I'm gonna bring it in, and I'm just gonna click twice to place it where it is. All right, so this is good. It gives me an image. I can go through the same process of scaling and tracing this, not tracing necessarily, but using it as a reference to draw. But first thing I want to look at is these dimensions. So I'm going to have a dimension that I'm going to reference. This is obviously an issue. I really don't even know what that number is. This is because of a setting. if I go to Preferences under the SketchUp window in Mac or under Windows in Windows and click on OpenGL, I have this option, Use Maximum Texture Size. If I turn that on, I get a little warning that says, this is potentially going to slow down SketchUp. That's okay. I'm just using it as a reference right now. When I click Yes, you'll see what shows up is a much clearer file. So this I could actually use to come in and say, place a reference line and use that to scale this drawing. From that point then, I could actually come in here and I can, again, not going to be able to snap because there's not actually points. It's a bunch of pixels rather than actual lines, but I could use as a reference and type in my dimensions as I go. In this case, I'm going to be 26 foot. If I want to just draw the garage in, I could come over the dimension at the bottom, 24 foot. Get that square in there. Offset my wall width. And then bring that up, maybe 9 feet. So you can see how that can be used real quick and easy. It's great. I don't have to have a set of plans next to me that I have to refer to constantly. I can actually look at the dimensions right on the screen and draw very precise dimensions around this plan. So now, because I use those dimensions rather than just clicking, I can tell this is an exactly 26 foot wall. This is exactly a 24 foot wall. So there you go. Just a quick overview of using images as references for detailed drawings. Again, remember, import, draw a line, group and scale, use maximum texture size, and then don't be afraid to use dimensions rather than just snapping on points to get accurate dimensions into your drawing. Thank you.